Nigerians in different parts of the world, they are some of the most industrious people that I know. When you see Zimbabweans with 90% unemployment, when you see Eritreans, when you see all the Sudanese or the Malians or the Gambians going to Europe and America, it is not because they like it. If there were conditions that were suitable in Africa, they would struggle at home. Yes. But when you hear a young person say he'd rather die
at sea
than to remain at home, that is not human. The human nature is self-preservation. When a human being says that, there must be something so grave at home, something so dehumanizing. That is what African leaders sometimes do not know. When I see them in limousines and in private jets, with motorcades, I say, these men, not all of them, these men, who are they? Where did they come from that they are so insensitive that they go to countries and receive 21 gun salutes and their people are dying at home? Who are they? Are their hearts made of stone? Do they have eyes and they do not see, ears and they do not hear? Are their consciences so seared? I ask. And many Africans ask even in their silence. But we cannot keep quiet. We must continue to raise our voices, talking not with the arrogance that will inflame their anger, but with the firmness and the clarity that will, in the fullness of time, open their eyes. Mm-hmm. That is our patriotic duty. These are the people who lend themselves to being used by the erstwhile colonial power.
Yes.
We must liberate them from themselves. They are capable of being liberated. Mm-hmm. They have, such individuals have very short-term goals, the goal of self-gratification.
Yes.
They are the ones who actually destroy their countries through corruption. Oh, the comrade bourgeois has always been very dangerous because they are the ones who steal from Africa and they have no faith in Africa. They keep their loot in other parts of the world. And in other parts of the world, such individuals in China, whether they call them comrade bourgeois or call them anything else, when they are caught, they are executed as an example to others. There is no shortage of them. And somehow this comrade bourgeois, they have the uncanny habit of getting into public office. They are the ones whom we elect in many African countries. And once we elect them, they think they are holding our brief, but they are holding their own brief, and they are asking to be bought by any person who is in the political purchase market.
My goodness.
These are individuals who must be identified. I'm suggesting, therefore, that the African electorate must also be enlightened. The African electorate's affinity for thieves is something that is scaring. We elect into office individuals whose only claim to fame is that they are thieves, to use the words of Liberia's Boima Fanbule, they steal on an industrial scale. We must do that. Is it going to be easy? Perhaps not. Experience has shown that it's not easy. Must we give up? No, not at all. Must we speak about and against it? Yes, because history has also demonstrated that which is clear must be repeated times without number so it becomes as clear as gold. Will it be achieved in like instant coffee? No. Therefore, this is not a sprint. This is a marathon race. It's not for the faint-hearted. Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to share my thoughts, my hopes, and my frustrations. But I remain optimistic.